watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Shout out to Blue Blood Sports TV.
You're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Shout out to Blue Blood Sports TV.
You're watching Blue Blood Sports TV. Hola, habla Cindy. Está viendo Deportes TV.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, after defeating former two-time welterweight and at the time, current WBC world champion Showtime Sean Porter, undefeated, unified welterweight world champion, boxer superstar Earl "The Truth" Spence Jr. has been rumored and linked to multiple fights, mainly the one with former two division world champion Danny Swift Garcia. As Danny Garcia entered the ring after Errol Spence defeated Showtime Sean Porter to call him out, and the report surfaced that there's a possible deal in place for Errol Spence to face Danny Garcia January 25th, Fox pay-per-view in Brooklyn at the Barclays Center. With that said, you know, we know that Showtime Sean Porter defeated Danny Garcia for the vacant WBC title to become the champion after both men lost to then undefeated welterweight king Keith "One Time" Thurman, who unified the division, later vacated the WBC belt due to inactivity, and then lost his WBA belt to 8-division Filipino superstar boxer Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao, right? So with that said, Danny Garcia and Showtime Sean Porter faced off against one another to see who was going to host that WBC green strap after Keith Thurman vacated it. That's how we got to Showtime Sean Porter facing off against Errol Spence Jr. in the unification bout, as Sean Porter held the WBC and Errol Spence held the IBF. Errol Spence now holds the IBF and the WBC. Going into a future showdown with Danny Swift Garcia for the unification. Unified, right? So with that said, Sean Porter defeated Danny Garcia. And going into the fight with Errol Spence Jr., as bets and odds have opened up for Vegas, Danny Garcia is a better betting favorite over Sean Porter to defeat Errol Spence Jr. And ironically enough, as I put it, Showtime Sean Porter beat Danny Garcia. Now, you know, going into a fight, they're claiming that styles make fights. Thus, the reason why they're giving Danny Garcia a much better chance to beat Errol Spence than they did Sean Porter. Not to mention, they feel like Errol Spence's stock dropped after his fight with Sean Porter. Here's a quote from some of the Las Vegas men in charge of the bettings, right? He says, quote, "Garcia is a similar level to Porter, having only lost to Porter and Keith Thurman on a split decision. I thought he won that fight personally." This is the fight he's talking about. He's referring to Danny Garcia and Sean Porter. As for Spence, the Porter fight slightly lowered his stock. So he's favoring, but because Sean Porter had a great outing against Errol Spence, they're saying that his stock dropped, and that's the reason why they closed the gap for Danny Garcia versus Errol Spence, right? So Sean Porter opened up as 1,000 minus 1,000, for the Errol Spence fight, and stayed and hovered at 800, as Danny Garcia is opening at 600. So Danny Garcia has a much better chance, according to Las Vegas, to beat Errol Spence than Sean Porter did. And they're stating that due to the fact that Sean Porter had such a great outing against Errol Spence, that dropped Errol Spence's stock, and they like styles make fights. So they like Danny Garcia's style better, to better suited to defeat Errol Spence than Sean Porter's, than that of Sean Porter's, right? It is now seen also Vegas, they favor Terrence Crawford. It is now seen that Crawford would be a clear favorite rather than a 50-50 in their fight should it ever happen, according to Vegas betting odds. So according to Vegas, If Errol Spence, after the Sean Porter fight, his stock has dropped so much that they will have Terrence Crawford as a clear betting favorite over Errol Spence. But when it was first mentioned, and, you know, it's rumored that it's a possibility, you know, and it's the hotbed, you know, for a fight in the sport of boxing, it was 50-50. Now that has clearly dropped, and Terrence Crawford would be the clear betting favorite to beat Errol Spence should they ever match up in the future, according to Vegas odds makers. Wow. Styles make fights, you know, maybe Vegas knows something we don't know. I would think that, and I would favor Errol Spence to beat Danny Garcia in a much cleaner fashion than he did of Sean Porter, because styles make fights. I agree, styles make fights. But I think that, you know, Danny Garcia is a counterpuncher. He will stay on the outside. You know, it'll be a much cleaner. I think that Errol Spence, you know, style and his discipline would allow him to beat Danny Garcia in a much cleaner fashion. Would it be easy? No, by no means. Does Danny Garcia have an opportunity to beat Errol Spence? Absolutely. Will he beat Errol Spence? I don't believe so. So I believe that styles do make fights, but Sean Porter, style of staying in your chest, making it ugly, making it a dog fight, gives him a much better opportunity, I believe, in my opinion, to defeat Errol Spence than that style of Danny Garcia. Now, when you're dealing with Terrence Crawford, that's a whole different animal. Terrence Crawford has no glaring weaknesses. He has great foot movement. He has a great high ring IQ. He has power. He's accurate. You know, so all of those things, I could understand Vegas saying that, Terrence Crawford. Them saying that Terrence Crawford would be a clear favorite is another thing I disagree with. Slight favorite? Okay. Clear favorite? No. You know, it's still a much, much difficult fight than people want to give it credit for. You know, like I stated, I feel like people are just being prisoners of the moment, and not and for the mere fact that leading up to this fight, Sean Porter was being discredited. He wasn't given the credit he deserved going into the fight. So a lot of people feel like he did better than what they thought he was, or they feel like Errol Spence was exposed. And I think it was neither. I think that Sean Porter did what he normally does. He's a great fighter. And I think that Errol Spence was just in there with a great fighter. Errol Spence had to adapt to that style of Sean Porter, and he did so and was successful. So I feel like a lot of people feel like Errol Spence was exposed because they thought that Errol Spence was just gonna Mack truck right through Sean Porter. And I told people that wasn't gonna be the case at all whatsoever. But yet people took it and ran with it because they're not in favor of Sean Porter's style. They're not in favor of Sean Porter's, maybe his lifestyle. They're not in favor of Sean Porter's father, trainer, and manager, Kenny Porter. You know, and all these things played a factor in Sean Porter being discredited for his skill set and not given enough credit for what he does. And he's never been blown out in any fight. He lost a very, very razor-close thin fight to Keith Thurman. He lost a very, very razor-close thin fight to Kell Brook. Either of those fights could have went in the opposite direction, and Sean Porter could have easily been undefeated going into the Errol Spence fight. But that's not looked at because of Errol Spence, Sean Porter's style, and you know, the fact that his father and his dad, his trainer, is not in favor of the public all the time, you know, and, you know, so Sean Porter was overlooked in this fight. So he didn't overachieve. He achieved as he normally did. It's just that the public perceived him a certain kind of way and thought that because they felt Errol Spence is a destructive force, that he was just going to mow through Sean Porter, and that wasn't the case. And so now they're saying that Errol Spence's stock has dropped, and I think that's the furthest thing from the truth. But I would favor Errol Spence to beat Danny Garcia in a much cleaner fashion than he did Sean Porter. But that's all I got for y'all. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hey, like, comment, and subscribe. You haven't subscribed? Hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shouts out to the entire LDBC. Shouts out to New Media. Shouts out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
The Blue Blood Sports TV, baby, from the Empress. Much love.